Good afternoon, everyone. Presenting a bit of this analysis on our up and coming project in our company, which is educational software development for the iPad platform. It's based on the Philippine cartoon character. You know Philippine? Is that come? You know? A bit, it's a very popular cartoon character. So it will be a background on the project. The business case of doing this software is looking at the success of the Angry Birds platform on the iPad and iPhone. We have decided to embark on a similar project, but it's an educational game based on the very popular Philippine cartoon character. We are going to tap a new model of software sales where we just deploy to the online store and sales are done continuously, perpetually. We are going to be adopting the risk management methodology as advised by the PM Body of Knowledge, which is first is to have a risk plan and to identify the risk. Analyze the risk, then the responses to the risk, and then monitoring and control of the risk. So the start of the risk plan is given by our project scope, which is you can see on the presentation. A few points to note here is one is that it's an educational math game. It's for the iPad platform only. We will be doing the development for the iPhone platform. And our target group is children aged to 6 to 10 years old. And the game will have a central theme of the Philippine and Philippine cartoon character. Right, so this is our project scope that we're going to use for our project plan. This is the overall schedule of our project. Can be divided into four major sections, which is the purchase of hardware, development of a storyline. In developing any game, you need to have a story to the game. So, the more storyline is one of the major sections of the game. The third major section is the actual development of the source code writing and testing of the game. And finally, is Apple Store. Because in order to deploy to the iPad platform, you need to be authorized on the Apple Store. So the total duration of the project is 138 days with a total cost of about 130,000. You can see the breakdown of each section in the respective boxes. As you can see, the biggest chunk which will come from the development is 400,000 in here. This is our simplified Gantt chart. This is what I've been using to do the subsequent risk analysis of the project. Okay. So from the Gantt chart, we actually identified a critical path. The numbers in the boxes are same as the numbers in our work breakdown structure, which we used to develop the Gantt chart. And we can see that our critical path is actually 130 days. Which is actually interesting because initially based on the Gantt chart, the project duration was only about 120 something days. But during the critical path, we realized that we have 138 days on the critical path that we should actually be monitoring along the critical path to make sure that none of the items on the critical path are delayed. You can see there's a go-no-go point here, number 43. So item 43 is actually approval from Apple to register as a content provider. So this is actually done early on in the project because if the approval is not obtained, then the whole project will collapse. So from the critical path and using the work breakdown structure, we have developed a risk breakdown structure. When we group the risk breakdown structure again, similar to our project plan, which is four major item, which is hardware, storyline, development, Apple Store, and also we added an additional risk factor, which is an external risk. I think to keep it simple, I've just actually included some and not all of it, because if it's all, it's going to be So after determining the risk structure, we are now able to construct a probability impact matrix using the identified risk structure. So for this project, I will only be doing the probability impact matrix for the cost and the time factor. Right? So for the cost, probability impact matrix, this is the outcome. So a few points to note. First one is that almost all of the hardware is very high probability but very little impact on your cost, because if you go and purchase an iPad now, you are most likely to wait for about 3 to 4 weeks before it can get delivered. But because the cost does not change, so it's very low impact to the cost for being purchased. Next item to note is that the game that we have done is not approved. So this is a very high impact item, because at this point in time, the development is already it will be completed, because the game is completed development, it's just submitting for approval to Apple. So at this point in time, Apple does not approve the game, then it's going to be very costly for us, which is basically the cost of the whole project is $430,000. But the probability of this is very low, because Apple has given very clear guidelines on how to get approval of games. The storyboard risks are generally grouped around the medium probability low impact. The extended risks are very negligible impact in terms of cost. And finally, you can see that development risks have actually very high cost impact, as you would expect, because it's the biggest cost contributor to the whole project. The next item will be is the probability impact matrix for the time factor of a project. You can see that the boxes have been shifted around. Now the out of stock carries a substantial impact to the time of the project, because without the hardware, the project cannot start. So the whole project will be shifted forward until the hardware is delivered. So it's going to have a substantial impact on the project. The blue boxes have been swapped. Previously, rejected application was down here, game number was up here. Rejected application is something that's done early on in the project based on our critical path. So if the company is not approved as an Apple content developer, then again, the whole project will be shifted forward until the approval is obtained. Okay, the storyboard risk was somewhere around here earlier in terms of the cost. Now in terms of time, it's shifted up, because we need to get the storyboard right before you start development, because the storyboard is set or pretty much determine the success of the game. And again, the external risks are here, it's not shifted anywhere. In terms of the time, the external risk has very little impact. The external risk actually has impact in terms of our sales volume, not in terms of the project deliverables. And again, we see that the development risk is quite substantial also, in terms of time to the project. Okay, so taking into account these two matrices that we have done, we now prioritize our risk. So we can see that our risk, the top two is the development risk, which is the green boxes you see on the top right corner of the matrices now, followed by the storyline, and again development risk, and then you have the other risk coming down here. Even though the Apple Store risk is actually number 8, but it is something that we need to monitor constantly, because it has basically can make or break the project, because if we don't get an approval for the developer, content developer, then the whole project will collapse.
This priority one, how does it read?
Sorry?
One stands for high
priority. This is in terms of the incremental priority of the list, from 1 to 9. 1 is most important, mine is the least important. Hardware is the least important. Mm-hmm. Hardware has very little cost, but with your time back, which you can manage. So having identified the risk and their priorities, we can actually construct a risk response table, which is in the project risk register. So I'll just read out some of it to you, the first two actually. For the development risk, one of the risks is lack of experience in our developers, because you all come from telco background where you do a lot of non-user interaction development. So this is our first development where we have a lot of user interaction through the iPad or key gestures. And so the way we plan to manage is to send for adequate training for all our developers, or actually to hire a content developer who's quite experienced to lead the team. A possible response to a lack of resources is again to increase fund to hire additional programmers, and also we will do a continuous hiring process. That means we will constantly interview people and keep them in the database should any of the contract programmers decide to leave before the project is completed. For the storyline, this is the story of the board game. You'll hire a subject matter expert. Usually it's those who are very familiar in 6 to 8 year old mathematical education, and also those who have experience in very interactive learning for children. So also we plan to do field trials, which is free downloads, probably a portion of the game, just to get your feedback. So again, there's two screens of the risk response up to the the point to know is that the hardware, we plan to accept all risks as there's no alternative. There's no way for you to develop for Apple platform unless you have an Apple computer. And there's no way for you to test on the iPad unless you actually have an iPad. So there is literally no option for us here except to accept all the risks in terms of the delay of the development of the hardware. And also Apple has announced that they will be upgrading the operating system soon. So we also have accepted that there will be changes in the future to the platform should the operating system be released before the project is completed. Okay, so that's pretty much my presentation. The last portion is the monitoring control. So what I'm going to have is a source code review. For those who are not familiar, source code review is a session where, let's say I'm the programmer, I will explain to all my peers, it's like a peer review, or why I do the source code or my programming the way I did, and what's the results and what's my logic behind it. So during this peer review, so people can question me how I approach the problem, what's the expected output. Right, so having a source code review is actually good because it helps you to gain understanding of your problem through the different ideas from your team members. And so we also have a project progress meeting, which is pretty standard for our projects. Most project progress meetings will occur when a milestone is completed, or in our case when a specific module of the game is completed. We also have a yearly financial review, because the running cost of the development period is extremely high, so we need to make sure that there's enough funds for us to pay the contract developers who are hiring. And finally, it's the risk review meetings. Risk review meetings is also happen at usually among the life cycle of the project from one stage to another stage to determine if the company is willing to move forward and whether we have enough funds to move forward. That's pretty much the end of it. And if you have any questions or answers, questions. Anybody who doesn't know Pin? You know what I mean, Pin?
When will the app be released? When will the app be released?
So according to the schedule, it's about 5 months development. So sometime first quarter next year.
Why no financial projections are being
done? Actually, there is the work breakdown. It is based on see, there's a cost here. See, the cost is based on the biggest down. The cost.
No, projections are this cost. How about revenue?
Revenue. Only then you can know whether the project is worth spending. Oh yeah, yeah. I didn't really manage the position because it was the project itself was it's a first project for us, so we have no historical data, and it's something that we have actually decided to take the risk because we believe this is the way for us to go. We still have our existing big projects, but the way that software says going on, this is the way. So whether we like it or not, this is the risk that we have to take.
I agree, but you can also make some estimates, you know, based on some proxy data. So for instance, to give an example, you can look at the sales of similar products in a year. Then what percentage of the target market you may capture. So this, even though you know the figures are very hazy, but gives you an indication. And if you work on a target market of say 5% of the market or whatever it is, then you know what revenue will be.
Okay.
And then again, you will probably have not thought about how you're going to market this product. Have you thought about it?
Ah, that's right, it's an Apple store.
Oh, you're going to the Apple.
Apple store, yeah.
How much would that cost?
329.
Per registration
as a company.
Okay. Then after that?
After that is as long as they approve your product, there's no charges.
No more charges.
There's that they take a portion of your revenue, and say you're selling 1 million, they probably pay about 50 cents.
This is what I wanted to should I have some figures there.
Okay.
Then that gives you a better idea of things. All in all, for the first attempt, I think it's good. A lot more things can be done. And, you know, okay, there is a variation in platform, variation in OS. What is the impact? So all these things have to be thought about. Okay?
The OS, I think the platform per se is not only a lot of changes. Is that the, they have announced a new OS, which is iOS 5, expected to be released the final quarter of this year.
The other key problem I feel that you may face is okay, changing the storyline. Suddenly somebody comes up with a slightly better idea. Okay.
Well, actually, it's in the word breakdown. There was a. Let me see if I can show you the word breakdown. So
is this storyboard, the storyline somewhat fixed? Nothing to change?
There's a review process in the storyboard. It's an iterative process, but the basic concept is pretty much fixed.
So have your developers been alerted about this possibility?
Yes, because actually, you can see, you can see there's three parts to the storyboard, which is the base game, level 1 and level 2. The base game sets the tone of the game itself, and that's pretty much fixed. Like actually paint and you paint is from the house and they want to go to the store. So along the way they will learn how to do addition and subtraction, and at the store they will learn how to do multiplication and division. So that's the storyline. So the storyline is pretty fixed. It is at level 1 is addition and subtraction, level 2 is multiplication and division. This one can change and have very little impact on the overall story. And because it's such a modular design that you can change the level ones and have no impact on the level 2 levels.
I mean, at least you can talk about that, you know? How variations can affect.
Okay, so any other questions? Okay, thank you very much for your time.